Hello to our community group leaders, participants. This is the Teaching Series Extra for Sunday, March 25th, 2018, and this is Palm Sunday. We remember on Palm Sunday, the Sunday that Jesus entered into Jerusalem, the triumphal entry. Of course, the week would end with his crucifixion, but the next week, Easter, would begin with his resurrection. And so we look forward to that Easter Sunday morning, April 1st. Quick programming note. Three Easter morning worship gatherings, 8:30, 9:45, 11 o'clock. And I appreciate those of you who are part of community groups that have moved your time. You're either moving at 8:30 or 11 o'clock to help balance out our crowds on Sunday morning. Thank you for your willingness to do that. But we're on Palm Sunday, and we're still walking with Peter through the last 15 hours or so of Jesus' life. And in the four Gospels, Peter is used as a literary tool. Whenever Jesus wanted to address the disciples, Matthew, Mark, Luke, or John says he spoke to Peter. So Peter really represents all of the 12 disciples. And in the same way, Peter personifies all 2,000 years of disciples who have lived since the earthly ministry of Jesus. In fact, if you want to see how you would have responded of the events surrounding Jesus' trial and crucifixion, just look at Peter. This is likely how you would have responded. And to think about this in a big picture, Peter really was all over the place. At one moment, he was overconfident. The next moment, he was fearful. At one moment, he was fatigued. The next moment, he was violent. He's just all over the place spiritually. And if that reminds you of anybody, it should remind you of you, that many times we are very scattered in our spirituality. But on this week, March 25th, we're going to deal with the fear of Peter. And you've heard me ask this question before. It's a question by Jan Johnson and some of her writings on the contemplative life. She says, what would your life look like if you weren't always afraid? And I think that's worth some time to pray through that and to meditate on that. What would your life look like if you didn't respond to fear? Now, let's make a distinction here. We all have feelings of fear. And it's not the feelings of fear that are the problem. That's very natural. It's how we respond to those feelings of fear that is the difference between cowardice and courageousness. So, just an illustration that you can use in your community groups. Shortly after the 9/11 attacks, Baltimore Symphony was performing downtown one evening. All of a sudden, the lights in the concert hall went out. Of course, with 9/11 so fresh in our collective consciousness in America, people started squirming in their seats. Is this another terrorist attack? Well, toward the end of the number, the lights came back up, the audience was relieved, but what people noticed, or what they noted, was that through those moments in the dark, the symphony just continued to keep on playing. And for me, that's a great example of choosing to be courageous in the face of fear. We all have those feelings of fear. It's what we choose to do next. And so here we see Peter confronted with his fear of being identified as a follower of Christ, and he chooses poorly. But something would happen in his life with the resurrection of Jesus, and we'll see that next week, that he would be transformed into a person that he didn't lack fear. He still had fear, but instead of responding with cowardice, as we see him do in the denials of Jesus, he's going to respond with courage, as we see him do after the resurrection of Christ. So I just want you to consider this. Fear may be a green light. Whenever you feel those feelings of fear, we're tempted to stop, we're tempted to treat that as a red light, but it actually may be a green light from God to go, to take that next step. Even though it's scary, even though it frightens us, fear may be a cue to you being obedient to the Lordship of Jesus Christ, for you to take that next step. Now, we're not called to be foolish. We are called to be faithful. So whatever fear you face, maybe it's an opportunity for you to practice obedience. Thank you so much as you lead in your discussion groups, as you lead in your community groups. As always, I'm thankful to serve alongside you. And my prayer for all of us is that we would live fear-free lives, and we would live courageously out of obedience to Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless you this week, and we look forward to Easter together. Bye-bye.